You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment. From the AfterBuzz studios in Los Angeles, California, and streaming live on Ustream, this is AfterBuzz TV for Jersey Shore. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest Jersey Shore news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, picking up where the show leaves off and the buzz continues, it's AfterBuzz TV for Jersey Shore.
Welcome, welcome, AfterBuzzers. I am here with Kameron Safford, Nicolette Gaona, right? Is that, did I say it right?
Gaona.
Gaona. That's very exotic. Is that Italian or something?
Spanish.
What do I know? Anyway, we have another amazing episode of Jersey Shore called Three Men and a Snooki. And I feel it should be called Snooki is a Whirlwind.
Snooki is a lot.
Definitely. It was definitely one of the best episodes by far, so far, I think, at least.
Well, right on. Well, why don't we get into Deena right off the top, as she kind of stirred up a you know, trouble right off the bat. Well, not off the bat. I mean, there's a pregnancy scare, and it's kind of funny, and so she drives a little bit of the story. So I do want to talk about her. Girls, I've never gone through a pregnancy scare because I am not a girl. So, you know, not that you guys have gone through it, but it's more relevant to you.
Let me take this one because I actually know firsthand what it feels like to have to take a pregnancy test on TV. Let me just say that when Deena was going through this on the show, it reminded me of myself when I was doing the Saddle Ranch show and I had a pregnancy scare. And there's no feeling in the world like lining up the pregnancy tests and the camera guy zooming in at the same time that they're getting like reaction shots and you're like thinking about your family. I mean, it was like giving me a hot flash thinking about that poor girl in there doing that. Poor Deena. But thank God she's good. Especially since she's been drinking the entire time that she's been here. I love how she's got like a cocktail and she's like, I think I might be pregnant.
Drink the baby. I'm just kidding. I'm not going to say all that.
Way to go, Deena.
I mean, you know, just the fact that like, yeah, she's totally crazy. I love how she's talking about, oh, you know, my family's good. I'm embarrassing my family.
Now right. She is.
Yeah.
Making out with Snooki and lifting your skirt up at the bar. Don't worry. They love
making
that.
Making out with that crazy girl, Brittany. Okay. If anything, exactly. That should be the disappointment right there.
I mean, she's literally made out with at least two girls in this season, pulled her dress up, fallen down 100 times drunk. But her family's really going to be upset about the pregnancy scare. I love that about her.
And you know what? God only knows what they must be thinking. I mean, I go back to Snooki on the... we'll get into Snooki. But just the fact that every time they call their parents, it's like it's the parents' fault. Like, whoa. What, the right. Parent... Like, you're in Italy. You're an adult. I have nothing to do with your life if right. I choose not to.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I don't know. You don't really hear a lot of what... Well, that goes back to Snooki. We'll talk about later, but you don't really get to hear the other side of the conversation, but their phone calls home are hysterical to me, no matter who they're talking to.
Especially Snooki, because she just goes off, you know? She's like, you're not listening!
That's right. Well, why don't we get into Snooki, since she is the main catalyst of tonight's episode. I mean, basically everything that happens involves her, but... Before I get into it, let me just say KWOW is obviously not here with us, so I am taking the reins. And I'm doing it from within the booth, so that's why I sound a little bit different than the lovely ladies. But nonetheless, he will be back next week, and we're prepared to give you an amazing show. So, Snooki, why don't we start with JWOW and her. Obviously, last time we left off, JWOW was mad. She was trying to get Jionni to come back, but it wasn't working out. Snooki was hating on her. And JWoww finally is just like, you know what? I'm kind of over it. Like, I tried to do something nice for you, but you just don't care about, you know, you just threw it back in my face.
Right.
The thing that I found interesting was how quickly JWoww actually got over that. The next day, like, she ended up apologizing. If I were JWoww, I would have been like, last night you cried. You told me you hated me. I chased your boyfriend through the streets of Italy after you acted like a jerk for hours. If anyone should be apologizing, I really thought that Snooki should have been the one to apologize. I couldn't believe JWoww was like, I'm a shitty friend. I mean, I thought, I don't know. I just didn't think it was her fault.
I agree with that totally, because if I was JWoww, you know, being a good friend that she was that night, you know, I was thinking if I was Snooki, you know, I would want her there with me that night and trying to get me through that night. You know, instead, Snooki went the total opposite direction and just went off on her and just calling her, you know, so many horrible names. And if I was JWoww, I would have laid in that bed until I felt 100% better and been like, you know what, you can deal with this on your own because I'm obviously, you know, not important to you right now. You know, and I feel like they should have had a talk about it. I feel like she shouldn't have just forgave her right away.
No.
I mean,
I didn't really see Snooki take responsibility for anything for that night.
She didn't.
She cried the whole time and said she felt awful like 100 times. But she never really, even with Jionni and with JWoww, she was like, you should have been there for me today instead of I'm sorry for what I did last night. And then Jionni, it was like, you shouldn't have left me instead of I'm sorry for lifting my dress up and acting like a whore. The club.
Right. You know? I mean, I have a lot of things to say about that whole situation. Can I get into that?
Well, before we do, I do want to say my last thing is that, you know what? We'll kind of get into this with more in predictions, but, you know, I don't like the breaking up of Jenny and Snooki. I don't like what this is doing to Snooki. And, you know, JWoww, I think she apologized quickly for the fact that she wants both of them to stay cool, because you know what, they are very good friends and it's not worth you know, them breaking up their friendship over, you know what I mean?
That's true. And Snooki probably felt bad. I mean, she really did feel bad enough the next day with everything else that was happening to her. That's big of JWoww to just kind of end it and not really give her a hard time about it. Very different than how I would have handled it.
Right. I mean, I still feel like they should have at least talked about it, you know, and just got it off their shoulders, because who knows if one other night they're going to get into another fight and it's just going to be a more of a blow up because they didn't talk about it. You know what I mean? So to me, I felt like they should have at least got that out of the way.
Yeah, I agree.
For like the next time something like that happened.
Fair enough. Well, let's talk about the root of the problem, Jionni. All right, go ahead, Nicolette.
I'm sorry. I just have a lot to say about this section because honestly, like, I've been in that situation before where, you know, your boyfriend just leaves you and it might not even be for that type of reason, or it could have been for a really stupid situation. So honestly, I feel for both of them. You know, I feel for Snooki, you know, that's a horrible situation to have your boyfriend, you know, just leave you like that, especially coming all the way to Italy. Like, you just don't leave your girlfriend after 6 hours. Like, obviously you guys need to work through it, you know, but then again, it's like you see Snooki here. And, you know, that's nothing. Yeah, if you want to have sex with your boyfriend, all right, why don't you wait till you get home and do all of that? You guys are at a club, enjoy your time, dance together, you know, and like you said, she didn't apologize for anything. You know, to me, I feel like she should have been like, you know what, and came up to the conclusion and been like, look, Jionni, you know, I did screw up, I did mess up, like, I'm sorry, like, let's work through this. Instead, you know, she was herself and just went crazy crying. I don't know what I did wrong, you know, but at the same time, it does suck if your boyfriend just leaves you, you know, especially goes all the way back to the U.S. when you're in France, you know, it's a horrible feeling. Like,
you mean Italy?
Oh yeah, Italy, same thing.
Ah,
right?
Come on.
France, Italy. Oh, I was never good in history.
Geography.
See? Okay. You know, I'm just going to pass it to you right now. I'm digging myself in a hole over here.
Okay. Well, what I agree with you, though, about your boyfriend leaving you, that is the worst feeling. And for a minute, I started to feel really bad for Snooks in this episode because it really feels like shit. But it does really feel terrible when that happens. On another note, though, I will say, I feel I'm just so conflicted about this whole situation for several reasons. One is, as far as Gianni's concerned, you're dating Snooki from the Jersey Shore. You know, she's filming the Jersey Shore right now. So she's going to be Snooki, not maybe not so much Nicole during this time. That being said, he made a good point when he said to her, when she's like, you're making me not be able to be myself. And he said, getting drunk, dancing with your skirt up and hooking up with girls, how is that not being yourself? And I wrote that down because that is, I mean, I don't really see her point. Like she, you can't have it both ways. You can't have a serious boyfriend and act that way and expect him to stick around and watch you do that on TV and not feel like a jerk himself. So I kind of don't blame him for leaving as much as I felt bad for her.
Exactly. And I feel like, you know, he shouldn't have overreacted like he did. I feel like there could have been a more mature way for that all happening. But because it is the Jersey Shore, they needed some drama there. You know what I mean? And they obviously brought that together. But I agree with you on, you know, what she said about, like, how's that not being me, you know, and all that stuff. And, like, what Jionni said. And I feel like, you know, that honestly does not mix in a relationship, you know. And that right there says that, like, okay, you need to figure out your priorities, you know. Yeah, you might love him, but do you love that more, you know? So,
well, we'll see at the end.
Yes.
Well, for me, it's just the fact I really don't like Jionni. I never have. And he has such a sneakiness to him. He lied like, oh, I'm in Rome. But you're not. You're still at the train station. Right. Second, like, even if you're in Rome, okay, you could take a train back. It's not irreversible.
Exactly. Yeah, I agree too. I question his motives a little bit because he's let a lot of stuff go that I kind of felt like, what is he doing? He's really maybe just in it to be with her for TV or whatever. I don't know. I agree with you, Phil. I don't know about him.
Yeah, he's definitely manipulating the whole. Is that
monopolizing?
Manipulating.
What's your strategy here?
Okay, you guys get what I'm saying. All
right.
We do. Okay, and I really think he's, like, you know, trying to just egg her on a little bit more. You know, I don't think, like I said, going around the right situation of the whole thing, you know, telling her one thing, and then he's like, well, yeah, I'm actually here. Like, I hate that. Just be straight up. Like, it's so annoying. Sorry.
Yeah, I definitely think he has an agenda, and I think it's more so than love. No offense to Snooki. I think it's because he wants to be with the brand Snooki, not the real Snooki.
Well, if you're dating, are you dating Snooki or Nicole? And I think they need to be separated.
Yeah. You know? I think he honestly wants to date Nicole, but he can't handle Snooki, which I wouldn't be able to.
You signed up. You know what you signed up for, yeah, though.
You did, but geez, what was my next point? I forget my point. But anyway, moving on to Karma Night.
Woo-hoo.
That was the best part.
That was amazing. So I started off with, first of all, their outfits for this were incredible. Like, I absolutely was cracking up. I love Ronnie at the door checking IDs.
Yes!
Mike was creeping with his sunglasses on. Pauly D DJing. I freaking loved Karma.
The girls looked amazing, actually. Those are their best outfits, I think.
I love
the
when
whole
they
time.
Do that.
I'm like, you know what? You guys need to be dressing like that all the time.
Yeah,
I mean,
love that.
My favorite is the fact that every day they kind of, to a degree, play make-believe by being on the Jersey Shore and all that. And most of them, you know, are kind of hitting their 30s. Well, not Snooki and Sammy, but certainly the guys, at least Pauly D in situation. And you see this come to full fruition with this one night of basically, I mean, literally, if they CGI'd in, like, certain people, it would be exactly like Karma.
Exactly. That was amazing. I love how they left the trash on the floor, too.
Yeah.
Like, nothing. And just because it's on right now, I just want to really laugh at how Snooki had a Corona in her hand this entire episode. Either a Corona or a beer in a cup. Even when she was in bed, this girl did not stop drinking the whole
thing. The good news is it wasn't the same one.
Yeah, exactly. But I love that about her. Keep it up, Snooks. She was amazing.
Yeah, and remember that part, your favorite part, is whenever they were talking about the makeup, remember?
Yeah.
They were going on and on about, oh, am I looking okay? Throughout the whole episode, they're like, am I looking okay? The eyelashes, the makeup. I'm just like, oh, my goodness.
Well, and I do want to talk about real quick Mike outside. I love how Mike, actually, I don't love it. I hate it. How Mike is telling Snooki that they're best friends. He loves her. He's such a little painter. I mean, I love this about him. This is why he's on the show. But I don't like how he's like, oh, we're best friends. I would never tell anyone how you me and why, you know, whatever. And literally 2 minutes after that, he's inside in front of everybody. And he's like, yeah, I mean, Snooks was doing this while I was watching her friend get this in front of everyone. Like, what a piece.
It's so disrespectful.
What a piece. He sold her out so hard right there. I think he's going to get his about that in a minute. But
oh, yeah, definitely.
Phil, what do you think?
Oh, my God. Well, before we kind of get into that, I love how he stirred up the drama by trying to infuse Ronnie back into everything.
Seriously.
And Snooki goes at Ronnie, like, what did you say to him? Like, the reason why Ronnie said that comment was because he just wanted to agree with the situation so that way he could just be done and rid of it, as opposed to, you know what I mean? And that's kind of the big thing. That's why JWoww did what she did today, is because she didn't want another confrontation. She knew, let's just diffuse everything and just say, I was at fault. Rather than saying the truth, which is, Snooki, you know what? You're kind of at fault and you're yelling at everyone. I mean, the prime example that I can give is Snooki on the phone with her dad. She's yelling at her dad as if he did anything. And she's like, you don't understand me. You're not getting me. You're not getting my emotions. You have no idea what I'm talking about. Then why are you even calling him?
Yeah.
Also, did you guys see the point where he asked her, well, what did you do? She's not going to tell her dad what she did, because obviously if he was in that situation, you know, and that was somebody he was with, he would have probably, you know, would have left too mad or something like that. You know?
I think it's all coming back to, again, Snooks takes no responsibility for anything that she does, really, except for the aftermath when she's just like crying and I'm sorry. She never even, when Mike was confronting her about that, she never even was saying it didn't happen, really. All she's saying is, you know, we're best friends. She doesn't say that never happened. She says, you know what happened. We're best friends and I love you. But she doesn't, with her dad on the fence. Like, everybody, even with Ron, with everybody, you never see Snooki. It all kind of, she's so much work, that girl. But she never really owns up to anything that she does.
Yeah.
And so
that's... Well, I think it's a bigger thing that everyone's kind of let her do this throughout her whole life. And no one's, again, called her out on it because they just don't want to deal with it. And so, you know, throughout life, she's gone thinking that this is okay.
Yeah.
When it's really not.
I mean, it's really not. But at the same time, it's kind of got her where she is so far. So, I mean, it's sort of working for her, but not for long. I mean, it's going to blow up, I think, on her really, really. I mean, actually, it's starting to already blow up. She's just meltdown after meltdown. This girl, I love these white boots she has on right here.
I can't handle them.
Can we, real quickly, I mean, you know, we kind of get jabs of it throughout the episode in regard where Snooki and Jionni are kind of like Sammy and Ronnie.
Mm-hmm.
And JWoww, when she's speaking with Jionni on the phone, she's like, we don't need another Sammy on our... Or don't be Sammy, she says to Snooki, because Snooki, obviously, if she let it go then, she would change her mind 10 minutes later. And, you know, we've kind of... And Sammy, last episode, realized that, you know what, this is my relationship with Ronnie. And yet, in the background, if you notice, Sammy and Ronnie are still hooking up.
Whole time they're in the smush room. I did notice that, and I didn't notice Sam. Like, that was the old Sam.
Exactly. That was kind of cute, though. I was like, oh, Sam.
Yeah. But
like, that's the old me.
Hey, I don't mind Sam and Ronnie hooking up. I'm so over them fighting. Like, I hate the Sam and Ronnie drama at the club and stuff. So I think it's kind of nice that they're just in the background. Like,
so nice.
Now that they see how annoying it is, I kind of like that they've just chilled. They don't really fight with each other. You do still see them sleeping together on two separate occasions in this episode. But I kind of like Sam and Ronnie when they're not annoying me.
Yeah, so. I think they're going to be more funny, you know, like in predictions I'll get to that. But I definitely love them more loving than hating.
I like them getting along. Then they're not so freaking annoying.
Because we have drama right here with them, too.
that's all I can handle.
That's enough right now.
This episode wore me out with Snooki and Jionni.
I mean, again, I feel like, you know, again, this was such a Snooki episode.
Oh, yeah.
It really was. If there was no Snooki, there'd be no drama.
No.
And that's what the crazy part is. And I don't think it's, you know, I'll get more into this in predictions, but it's not going away.
No.
And until someone tells her, like, you're wrong, she's only going to continue to abuse and abuse and abuse.
I agree 100%. It's really going to come back to bite her.
She could definitely lose some good friends. You know,
she's gonna lose a lot more than friends, I think, in predictions. We'll talk about.
Well, that's the weird part. You know, going back to kind of Carmenite, which is just, you know, we're jumping around, but you know, Carmenite is just a shit show to begin with. The fact that JWoww said, you know what? If it comes down to a choice between her friends and Jionni, she's going to pick Jionni. And that, to me, was the craziest response or comment, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, and I disagree with Jenny on that one 100% because in this episode, I don't know if she really had a choice, but she went from, like, Jionni left her or whatever, and then she immediately was, like, on the phone with him, like, well, screw you, hangs up on him. Like, you left me. She turned it around on him, made it about him, hangs up on him, like, goes to the bar, goes to the club, dances at the club. Then she's doing, she really acted like the rest of the thing. She didn't give a crap about Jionni.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't really know if she would choose him over this. Because I don't think she did.
Yeah, and that conversation, you know, right there, you know, I feel like she was kind of, like, reversing the whole situation, which I do understand, though. Like, you know, he definitely was bringing her down. And, like, with Snooki, you know, she doesn't want to hear it. He obviously is telling her things that she needs to change because he probably does love her and wants her to change these certain ways, which isn't wrong. But at the same time, she's just like, no, I don't want to hear it. Like, F you, you're making me depressed, like, going off and just hangs up. Like,
and then she immediately, the karma night goes back to being Snooki.
Exactly.
So she doesn't care, and she's not picking Jionni over anything. She's picking herself and her friends and her coronas. And that's, I mean, it's evident.
But if she had to pick between Mike and Jionni, she would totally pick Jionni. So maybe that's what JWoww was going at. If she had to pick you or Jionni, she'd pick Jionni.
That's true.
Seriously, who would want to pick Mike?
Yeah, I would pick Jionni, and I'd probably be like 5 feet taller than him.
Well, do we think that Snooki and situation even hooked up? I mean, it seems at this point that it just had to have happened.
I think it totally happened. I think it totally happened, and I think in every episode that Mike's brought it up, Snooki's response has been so guilty, because she never says, you're a freaking liar, which is what I would do. I would flip a table and be like, are you kidding me? I would go psycho if some guy said that I did that. And in the like, disrespectful way that Mike is telling people she did it. Like, he's not even being classy about it. He's just like, she was like, I would kick his arse if he did that to me. And I would, and my reaction would be one that would speak that I'm innocent. She's just like, she never denies it. She's just like, Mike, you know what happened. We're best friends. It's like,
and I feel like
I've hooked up with a lot of best friends, Snooki, just saying. I mean, that doesn't deny anything. So
I feel like it's really descending, like, her negative towards that situation, because, you know, at first she was just like, you're a liar, I hate you, da, da, da. And now it's like, you know what happened, like, forget it. And I feel like the next time she's gonna be like, all right, whatever. You know what? It happened. Like, you know, like, I feel like it's just, like, totally going down.
I don't think that she's ever gonna admit it, but I just think you can just tell by someone's reaction if they're lying or not. And I really think Snooki
Here's my perfect transition into it. Okay, let's look at her record. First off, in season two, she said, you know, give me a bottle of whatever, and, you know, things happen. And she had a boyfriend going into Miami. And just let's look at this episode. She's mad at her boyfriend, sure. She's a little bit drunk, doesn't know what she's doing. And, oh, there's Vinny.
Oh, there's Vinny is right. And that was the night of karma, which is really, like you said, the shit show really began. You can't really feel bad for her at all by the end of this episode, because I think that she did do it. And she's hooked up with Mike before. She's hooked up with Vinny before. And the fact that she'll just go, I mean, just jump right into bed with Vinny, like, it's no big deal. And then you see her in the very end wake up and be like, what the F did I just do? Really, Snooki, really?
Yeah, she definitely doesn't want to be in love, that's for sure. I mean, if she's with Vinny, like, come on now. Like, it's not that easy just to...
I will say this, though. Old habits die hard. And when it comes to Snooki and Vinny, they got to hook up once every season. And so I guess they just had to get it out of the way. But, I mean, it kind of is perfect timing. She takes a break. She tells Jionni she doesn't want to talk to him for 4 days, and literally that later that night she's in Vinny's bed coming up for air. I can't imagine what her dad's thinking watching this episode, or any of them for that matter. But
I believe her parents love her. real quick before we get into a commercial, I'll let you guys have last comments, but I do want to say you guys, I don't know if you're familiar, but there's the CW show Hater by Mario Lopez, and Snooki was the first person that they showed, really? And she confronted her hater. What it is is celebrities, people that hate a certain celebrity, that celebrity confronts them. So there was a guy who hated Snooki, and Snooki confronted him, and he was actually a typical loser. I think he was just mad that Snooki wasn't dating him. And was going off of his family because they were like, oh my god, she's a whatever, she's a whore, blah blah. Lo and behold, she does convert him. So it was interesting to see how she's able to manipulate even, like, quote, her haters.
Yeah. If she was sitting in front of me, I'd probably be best friends with her and take her out for drinks in like 2 seconds. But when I watch her on TV, I'm just like, what is wrong with you, girl?
I mean, I think if she was right in front of me and she asked me for my honest opinions, I would tell her my honest opinions of, like, the relationship and, like, all that certain things. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, maybe she could be a good friend, but I wouldn't want to be seen with her, honestly, because that's just nothing I'd roll with right there, you know?
I agree. Anything else just in general that, you know, some of the smaller stuff that kind of we didn't cover in our big discussion, you know, any funny moments?
This was hilarious. This moment right here.
Oh yeah. We didn't talk about Deena's pranks and all that.
Deena is always getting pranked. That poor girl. At least she knew to cross her legs right there.
You guys are going to hate me for this, but if she was ever pregnant, it got squished right there.
Oh my God, I didn't even think about that. Well, think about how many times that poor girl falls down. I've seen her fall down like 3 flights of steps.
Yeah.
I can't imagine her being pregnant.
Oh gosh, she would just have to like sit there for days.
I mean, can't do anything, that girl.
Fair enough. Well, why don't we head into a commercial and then we'll be right back with our predictions. Is that cool with you guys?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right.
Want to find out what the AfterBuzz is about?
Janice is a drama queen.
This is the divide that is going to carry the series.
Give us a call. 424-256-1729. 424-256-1729.
It's television, and they want it to be as dramatic as possible.
I mean, it's Shakespearean.
You never know what goes on behind closed doors.
Find out why AfterBuzz TV is the number one source for after-show content.
Now, in the eyes of Jimmy, Snooki is a villain.
424-256-1729. 424-256-1729.
I mean, who would you guys rather hear that from? Your husband or your best friend?
The wig!
The wig will come out.
When the TV show is over, get your AfterBuzz on. Walk in the club
with no ID. Girls on my jackets. Right on, guys. Interesting. I don't know. I'm so used to, for those of you listening, this is the theme song for the Jersey Shore intro. And it's always interesting when you hear the full song versus just the short, you know, clip that you're so used to.
Go crazy. Get loud. I've never heard the whole song.
Really?
No. Oh.
Should we have our own Carmenite?
Yeah, we should. Oh, wait, go. When he's going down.
For those of you watching, we are having a dance party and these girls are going nuts.
Sucking on titties.
Yes.
Oh, this is a very good song.
The Jersey Shore.
I'm gonna have to get you to make me the mega mix.
I have the lyrics right here. If you guys want me to read them later as like a poetry.
Do it. So I bet it's really sweet.
It's interesting. I never really look at the lyrics much. You know what I mean? You hear the music, but you don't really hear the lyrics.
Yeah.
And as I'm reading, I'm like, wow, dude, this is pretty sexist.
All their songs are.
Yeah. Fair enough.
Special titties.
And now, your AfterBuzz TV predictions.
All right, guys, what are we predicting next week? Again, from what I saw, it was just more Snooki and how she envelops everyone around her.
Okay, what I'm pretty sure I heard Mike say in the clip of next week is that he gives Jionni the number of the guy that was there when Snooks allegedly performed fellatio on him. So I think Gianni's gonna call this guy, and then he calls
the unit.
Snooki.
By the way, the French name is the unit.
Oh, the unit. Okay, so I think Gianni gets a hold of the unit, confirms these allegations. Then you see Snooki go, stay out of my effing business. I hate you. Start throwing bottles. Start going crazy. Cut to Jenny being not a good friend, because I don't think at this point Jenny can do anything to save Snooki. That's my prediction. Bam.
Well, I think that definitely Jenny won't be a good friend to Snooki, because she's actually going to tell her straight up, like, look, you know what? You're not portraying yourself right. You definitely did something wrong to Gianni for sleeping with Vinny. You know, she's definitely going to be telling her, like, you need to know the truth, you know?
So, well, this will be Mike, too.
Oh, Mike. Well, yeah, that situation right there. Ugh.
So that would
They're all going to be getting into it on that right there. And I feel like she's definitely going to probably say something to Gianni. And that's when it's all going to go ham.
But, and, you know, like you guys said, Snooki's not getting mad in the way that she should. And, you know, although we saw bottles getting smashed, literally, I think the reason why she's doing that is because the truth is coming now out, not because he's spreading these lies.
Oh, yeah. It always sucks to get caught. It's like, are you mad because, are you sad or upset because you did it? Or are you upset because you got caught? It's going to be one of those, she's upset because she's going to get busted next week.
I mean, that's what it is. I mean, is it like usually like if they get caught, like, are they nice about it? Or, you know, like, oh no, like, you know, or do they get mad? Like, what is it? To me, I feel like if they're trying to be sweet about it, like, no, it like never happened, you know, like, I feel like that right there. But if they get mad, I feel like that's more like.
She's going to be mad she gets caught next week.
She is. And what do we think about she's going to tell also Gianni about the Vinny hookup.
Mm-hmm.
So what are your thoughts on that?
He's just going to, I feel like he's going to hang up the phone.
I don't know how he's going to react, because I'm sure he's probably going to be mad for a little bit, but I've seen tweets from Snooki, like, not recently, but as of a few weeks ago, where she was still talking with Gianni. And so this had to be after they were done filming. So at some point I think he forgives her, but I don't know after watching all of this if he's still forgiven her. So it's going to be interesting to see how
that
he reacts.
That is true.
Yeah, so I think that there's going to be a moment where they get back together, but I don't know if that will be...
Because they're seeing it right now.
Yeah, because he's going to see a lot of things right now that he might not know about.
Oh, my gosh.
That is very true. But I've got some words of advice for Snooki.
All right.
And, guys, with that, it is our show. We appreciate you coming in, or tuning in, rather. Well, we'll be back next week. We didn't watch the after show tonight because we have a full lineup of shows for AfterBuzz TV on Thursday night, so we didn't want to slow down the process and kind of weaken our after show with limited time. But we will discuss it next week for sure, and KWOW will be back. Girls, anything that you want to promote for yourselves, whether it's your Twitter handles, anything of that nature, shows, whatever?
Yes, follow me on Twitter, Nicolette Gaona. And also, Wednesdays at 9 p.m., 90210.
There you go. Night. And, Gaona, for those of you on audio podcasts, how do you spell that?
It's Nicolette Gaona.
Get it, girl.
There you go. And Cameron?
I'm at Cameron Safford on Twitter, with a K.
With a K, yes. Not the usual is with a C.
Yeah.
But we spell it European style, baby. Italian.
Get it.
Right on. Well, guys, and for those of you very, very few people who probably watch AMC's Breaking Bad, we will be doing a live season finale after show at the John Lovitz Comedy Club October 9th. The good news is you guys probably don't care, but... the kind of tie-in is that we will probably do something along the lines for the Jersey Shore season finale. So we're looking forward to that, and it's going to be in front of a live audience. So
that will be dope.
It'll be very fun.
I'm going to wear a Snooki bow.
Oh, my gosh.
Right on. Well, thank you, guys, and that's all we have for you this week.
From producers Kevin Undergaro and Phil Svitek, engineer DJ Jesse Janity, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. If you have questions or comments, be sure to buzz us at info@AfterBuzzTV.com. And you can find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter by searching for AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later, bitches.
Later.
Oh, and it wasn't us. It wasn't us. right? No.
So it wasn't us.
It wasn't us.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.